Welcome back to A View from the Stage. I'm here with my sidekick, Stephanie.
Hello.
And we are showing her new music from old bands. So today what we're going to do is we're going to do Ben Folds 5, One Angry Dwarf, and 200 Solemn Faces. Now this song is the opening track for their Whatever and Ever Amen record. Oh. And I think that this song is, I think it's really good.
Okay.
And what do you know about Ben Folds 5? You can see the album cover there. What do you think?
Well, it definitely looks like young. Yeah. Maybe 90s? Early 90s?
Mm-hmm. Mid-90s.
Mid-90s. Three guys?
Yep.
And I don't know much.
What seems ironic about that to you?
Usually bands have a lot more than three people. At least back in the 90s.
Think about the name.
And Ben Folds 5.
There's three.
There's three. What's going on there? I'm confused. Yeah, actually, I don't know what that means. Yeah, what's going on?
It's normally like if there was five people originally, and then two of them left, you'd have three. But I'm pretty sure that this band started out with three, and they're just like, let's call ourselves the Ben Folds Five.
Yeah, it's kind of funny.
Which I think that's Ben Folds' way of being Ben Folds. So
okay.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna listen to this song, and we're going to rate it and give our thoughts about it afterwards. So here we go. One Angry Dwarf, 200 Solemn Faces. Okay, One Angry Dwarf and 200 Solemn Faces in 3, 2, 1, go.
Piano. What?
Bye.
See, commit kiss my ass goodbye. Okay. One Angry Dwarf and 200 Solemn Faces are you. If you really want to see me, check the papers and the TV. Look who's telling who what to do. Now kiss my ass. Goodbye. He says it so subtly.
I know.
That's fun.
I just think it's funky. It's like funky.
Brilliant on the piano. Jeez.
That bass.
Wow. That's fun.
Sorry one day, yes you will.
Ooh, that sounds cool.
Push me around, cause I will, yes I will. You will be sorry when I'm big, yes you will, yes you will.
Wow, that's fun. It's like building up.
Such a good groove.
Wow.
Really different. Oh my gosh.
Thoughts.
It was a lot of piano.
Was very, very piano heavy because it was only a piano, bass, and drums.
That was fun. I'm like, in my head, I'm thinking like, does this guy ever run out of breath or get tired? I'm just like, there's so much energy in that. Mm-hmm. Like, how does he pull that off even live?
So Ben Folds Five was, they're from Chapel Hill, which is where my friend Nick used to live.
Oh, that's cool.
Actually, he has seen Ben Folds, I believe, twice. He said he puts on an incredible show.
And you said no guitar?
No guitar.
No guitar no whatsoever.
Guitar, no guitar.
Oh my gosh.
So I think that's...
So what is it? So it is a piano...
Bass. And drums.
And drums. Oh yeah, okay.
Because the piano takes the place of the guitar. It's the main instrument. And most rock music... The guitar is the main source of the instrumentation, unless you're the Police or someone like that.
I'm just sorry, that just blows me away. I've never heard anything like that. Is there anything like that nowadays, or is this just like a once and done?
I think that there's a few bands that came out during this time. That there's one band that the Morphine, who had a baritone sax player. And it was a baritone sax player, a bassist who only played two strings and a drummer.
Oh.
So that was pretty cool. And very different. Because that's what a lot of people in the 90s were doing. They were experimenting.
Yeah, I love that.
Because, like, everyone was sick and tired of playing the same old crap. So, like, what they did was they experimented with a baritone sax, or they experimented with a piano and bass and drums, no guitar.
Yeah.
I think that this is a terrific record. And what's funny is that... This record is, it starts off super happy, and you know, then you get Kiss My Ass Goodbye.
Yeah, that was kind of, that was surprising.
Yeah.
But he said it so smoothly.
But then there's also songs like Brick, which is about abortion.
Wow.
I don't know if I can say that on YouTube. There's also something else where what's the name of the song? Smoke, which is... basically about the Bible going up in smoke. So I think that it's very, very, very of its time, although it's still kind of relevant today, if you know what I'm saying. And so what would you rate this, babe?
I would say an 8.5. I liked it, and I want to know more. I think it's just interesting to see what they do, but I think the energy is what gets me.
Okay.
I like that.
Okay. All right. So we get an 8.5 out of this one here today. And I want to thank you so much for watching our channel. If you like the video, please leave a like. And if you want to subscribe, which I highly suggest you do so you don't miss any videos in the future, hit the button down below. And thank you so much. Be well and be good to each other.
Thanks.